Today, we are gonna fix destination folder access denied problem. Before moving on to the video, don't forget to leave a like. We encountered this error while placing the DLL files in our system folders. The first solution consists of two steps. The first step is to become the owner of the folder where we want to place the DLL file. To place the DLL file into the folder, we need the permission, which we can grant to ourselves only after becoming the owner of the folder. To do this, we open File Explorer. Then we click on this PC and then on Local Disk C. After that, we navigate to the Windows folder. Then we find System32 and Sys464 folders. We right click on System32 and then click on Properties. From the top, we click on Security. Then we click on Advanced. In the Owner section, we click on Change. In the white box, we type Users and click on Check Names. Then we click OK. As you can see, we have changed the folder's owner. After this, we take Replace Owner on Subcontainers and Objects. Then we click on Apply. After this step, a warning like this appears. The reason for this warning is that the files inside System32 are important and Windows wants to protect these files. To proceed, we click on Continue. There are like 30 files. We just click on Continue. This way, we have become the owner of the folder. And now, we can grant ourselves the necessary permission to place the DLL files. We click OK and close this window. The second step is to grant ourselves the necessary permission. To do this, we click on Edit. In my case, Users is already listed, but if it's not there, we can add it. To add it, we click on Add. Then, just like before, we type Users and click on Check Names. To add it, we click OK. As you can see, we have added users. After selecting users, we can see what permissions we have in the Permissions section. Here, we take full control and then click on Apply. To proceed, we click Yes. We click Continue as we did before. We click on OK and close this window. We need to apply the same steps for Sys464 as well. To save your time, I won't show the same steps for Sys464 in the video. What you need to do is apply the same steps we did for System32 to Sys464. This concludes the first solution. Now, we can check if the problem is solved or not. If the issue persists, we will move on to the second solution.